tonight in Toronto. Pascal Siakam, big time. 31 points. The Raptors, the top three-point shooting team in the league tonight, tied a franchise record with 21 made threes. That's Siakam there. The Raptors win 126-98. Great to have you with us from our Delta MSG studios. Bill Pito, Alan Hahn, and Wally Szczerbiak. Coming up next, it's the MSG 150 final, the Duke upset, and where that ranks all time in the history of upsets. But first, a lot to talk about tonight. And Alan, you talked about it in the pregame show, the Raptors' three-point shooting.
Number one in the league.
They hit from everywhere.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, it's incredible to think. Some of the shots they took, too, they just shoot with so much confidence. It, again, goes back to how much they focus on development, on player development, and a lot of the shooting. Some of these guys that have come into this team, it's not even just their shooting, Wally. I saw this team as, and I know they're defending champs. When you look at the roster, it's like, okay, there's two or three pieces that were part of the defending champs.
That's why I thought the Knicks had a chance tonight.
The rest of this roster is they just fine players, high motor, high energy, and they all can shoot. But you have a team that basically from the second quarter on completely outworked the Knicks. And one or two players on the Knicks played with heart all the way to the end. I think Mitchell Robinson is the main guy there. You saw him with that late foul. He was annoyed. He wasn't happy. He's embarrassed. Like, this is what you want some of the young players to see what's going on here and to be disgusted with it. I don't want to be part of something like this. You can see Mitch was just annoyed there. You need more of that, but at least from him, it's good to see. R.J. Barrett's homecoming. You know, he didn't shoot the ball well, but this starts to become now about some young players to start to learn from things like this, because some of the vets in this game did not play as hard as they should have.
And I didn't like the facial expressions at times with some of the guys.
Yeah.
It just looked like there was no fight. And we've seen fight in this team. We've seen close games and tough losses. But this one was, they were up 10 at one point. Bill was getting all excited.
The roller coaster was going up, tick, 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 tick,
Bill's holding on.
Look out below.
The second quarter.
Yeah. Knicks Pascal out. Siakam just woke up and just went crazy, and then Van Vliet went crazy. And then who are some of these guys coming in off the pitch?
And Malcolm Miller from Holy Cross.
30
They had
threes.
Seven players in double figures tonight.
I mean, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, 21 threes, obviously, for them, it ties a franchise record. But, again, I can't stress it enough, though, the way this team has been built was not going crazy in free agency or anything like that. It's just finding good players, finding very high motor players, and developing them.
They just looked like they were playing in a different speed than the Knicks.
Yeah.
You know, it just looked like when they made moves, they would get by the Knicks. When the Knicks would make moves,
26
they
second
would be...
chance points will prove that, wouldn't it?
Yeah. It just looked like they were quicker to everything, moving faster to the ball, just running up and down the floor quicker to rebounds. It just looked like they were just in such a rhythm and
lottery
such a
treating going on there.
Yeah, and they were thinking a step ahead too. That was the alarming part. You know, when you're on the road, you know the home team is going to be feeling their oats. They're going to be confident, sleeping in their own bed. But you know, these shots, they're wide open. They were getting to loose balls. It didn't seem like there was any Knicks that were like, wait a second, the ball's going there, so I should react and they anticipate.
Yeah.
That was a little bit concerning to me. And then once Bill started to go down the roller coaster.
Poor Bill.
No, there was nothing there to pull the brake.
I think I'm holding together pretty well.
Nothing there to pull the brake.
That's the thing, though, because the start went so well. They were hitting threes. The Knicks were. They were doing
Randall came out with 15 points in like the first.
They looked like they were attacking.
They were up 8 after 1.
We had talked about in the pregame about how they struggle with their in the paint. Right? We're talking about how they can't really finish around the rim. And they were making threes in this game, but they were still struggling in the paint early in the game. And then once the threes stopped going down, they really didn't have anything else. There's no other go-to with this offense.
I'm seeing when threes start to go down, guys start to hang their heads. Because now the joke is out. It's not a joke. Well, let's just say whatever. The rap on the Knicks is out that they can't guard the three-point line. You know, there's so many teams that are just coming in saying, oh, Knicks are giving up high percentage.
Well, this is the number one three-point shooting team in the league.
And now you're going up
you
against the Knicks who give up a lot of threes.
Yeah.
So it was
how do they change that, Wally?
You just got to take it personally. Each individual has to say, I'm not going to let this happen anymore. And then as a team, you have to start, kind of just setting the tone that we're going to defend the three-point line. We're going to become a better defensive team overall as a unit. There's nothing you can't just say it. You got to go out and do it. You got to enact it. You got to enact the game plan. You got to get tighter with your rotations. You can't give up any open threes, because once you give up one open three, if Siakam gets an open look, he hits one. The next one, when he's covered, is going to go in. That's how it works. You got to make guys uncomfortable, so when they do get an open three, they're like, I may never get an open three the rest of the game.
Yeah.
So I have to make this one, and that's when they miss those. That's what the great defensive teams do. They make you really like, oh, my God, I worked so hard just to get open. If I miss this one, I'm never going to get open again. And then all of a sudden they miss that one. Then they're like, oh, boy, now I'm going to have someone on me for the rest of the game. And that's how it should be. But the Knicks give too many rhythm open threes, which allow teams to get comfortable. And then the tough ones start to go.
They're scrambling a lot. That happens. But you know what else, too? I think what happens, you said when they start missing threes, the heads go down. If you can answer a three with a three, the momentum's killed. The problem is that they'll hit a three, you'll come down, you'll miss a three, they'll come down, hit the not 6 points. It just, that I think happens where
but then again,
they
the
aren't
Knicks
a good enough shooting team to be able to keep up with
keep
that
up.
Pace.
That's exactly
and
that's
the Knicks
a big part
guys
of the
are
issue.
Doing pretty well on the year. It came into this game the sixth best shooting 3-point team in the league.
Yeah, tonight not so much.
But you're going up against the Raptors, obviously, tonight.
Well, the Raptors actually give up. The Raptors will give up a lot of threes. They will give them up, but they have
the Knicks to attempt more. They took 41.
They did. No,
happy about that?
It did not work out. Hey, look,
they only made 12.
If they're making threes, you've got it, but you've got to keep up. You can't answer threes with twos. So, you know, this was a struggle tonight.
I need makers.
It's tough to watch, but I go back to the effort level, and I'm telling you, the young players kept playing hard. Some of the vets did not.